have a Sam Devlin 25-foot surf runner that I've just finished all the work that I need to do while it's upside down, and we're ready for boat flip. So we have the bottom is primed and finished, painted. There are three cradles on the top that will rotate along with the boat, and the height is such that when they sit on the building frame down below, the boat theoretically should still be level against waterline. So we'll see how that works out. Here's the engine hoist that we have at the bow. It's attached to the U-boat bolt that will be used for attaching to a boat trailer later on. There's side stays to keep it from moving sideways. We have it roped to the building frame, and also there's a 4-to-1 purchase, this boom bang that's being used to in case we need to move the boat fore and aft to have it set right on the building frame where it needs to go. We'll use that center adjustment that's attached to that red line. For the rotation, we have a come along that will be pulling on this red line. You can see it's attached to a spinnaker block up on the side of the garage there. It comes over the boat and wraps down, and it's underneath attached to a big eye down there. So that will be the line that rotates the boat towards us where we're standing now. The green line is going the other direction, and it has over here we have 4-to-1 purchase, and we'll have someone over here paying that line out, and it will be controlled by this wrapped around this horn cleat over here. The front of the boat doesn't need to raise at all, really, to be able to rotate. And the aft of the boat has to raise about 6 inches for the sides to be able to clear the frame as it rotates. So down at this end, we have another engine hoist set up similarly. And there's also another 4-to-1 purchase here that can be used to pull the boat aft if needed, and also to keep it from going forward. The building frame has all been disassembled except for just a handful of remaining 2x4 posts, but the boat right now is really effectively resting on these sawhorses. Okay, so what we'll do is I'll remove these last legs just right before the boat flip and rest the boat on those sawhorses while keeping it supported at each end by the engine hoists. All right, so that's the setup. You can see down here I have this the hoist secure at the bottom so that it can't tip over sideways. And also we have these lines which are adjustable in length, just like the front ones, to be able to move the boat sideways if needed. So we have people working those lines as needed.
These lines and these, you would call them pulleys, they're called blocks. These are all like sailing equipment. They're very, very strong. It looks like one rope, but these ropes are, you know, probably 8,000 pound test at least. They're very strong, and those blocks up there are very, very strong as well. Way stronger. You can lift the whole boat with any one of these. Now, if the boat goes falling or something, no ropes to try and catch it or anything. Just get out of the way, okay? It's just a boat. I can always fix it. I got lots of epoxy. Okay, I think we're ready. Okay, so the first thing to do is we need tension on both the green line and the red line and your line, Brent. What we want to do, we want to keep the boat from rotating in either direction right now. So go ahead, Jeff, and take all the slack out. Okay. All right. Now what we can do, the next step is going to be to get the sawhorses out. So we're going to crank each end up about 2 inches.
Okay, here we go. Back end coming up then?
Yep, back end, bring it up about 2 inches. Okay, hold right there. Okay, get this out of the way. More red line, Jeff.
Look him up. I can't tell. My line. No, it's good.
Yeah, go up. Too high is okay. Not high enough is not okay.
Oh, that's what I kind of wondered.
Okay, go ahead and crank.
We're rolling.
Hopefully I got enough.
Yeah, you can really see the tension there.
Yeah, you can. Yeah, really let the ropes cut off. Yeah. Yep. Use the green line. Actually, I shouldn't call it green. I guess.
That's fine. Yeah, do it.
Yep.
Looking good.
We pick up that flat. So Gary, how are we looking on that? How are we looking on that gunnel? Is that going to clear your frame?
It's closed. Why don't you go up a little higher again? So far we're clear.
Higher is enough.
Mine's loading up.
Yeah, I've got a lot of slack right now. You can probably a little more than the other thing. You got it. Close.
Okay, I'm gonna come up a little bit.
Okay, keep going. I think we're doing it. Good.
And then you
Yeah, I'm coming.
The rope off the edge there.
Yes.
There
you go.
Keep going. Keep going.
How are you doing as far as how much effort it is, Ray?
Oh, it's not
easy.
It's very easy.
All right.
Pull it back.
I think I
can just do it.
I'm out of purchase on this. The cleats got the whole
boat. Go ahead, you just ease, Ray. That means that he needs to Ray. And you need to ease more too, Grant. Yep.
It's 10 o'clock. Thanks, Grant.
Thanks so much for your help.
Thank you, Dan.
Appreciate it. Another 4 inches. Are we clearing up here though? Are we leaning against it?
Yep. It's leaning against it.
Okay. It's not touching it.
You want to turn it? You just kick the.
Okay. We want to rotate the boat some more.
So we need.
Jared, you want to play out? Oh, I see what's happening. Okay, the red line, we actually have to release because it's starting up. It's moving pretty easy. Okay, let's go ahead with the back one now, Brent. Let's go ahead and drop it on down. All right, this is...
Ready?
Yep.
Real slow.
Doing great. That middle cradle looks off, Jerry.
Okay, please go towards Jeff a little bit.
Yeah. Okay, want me to pull?
We need to release the red.
One down or not?
Gary, I'm going to release this blue rope. We need to tighten. I think we need to. Keep it tight for now, Jeff, because I want to pull the boat that way just a little. Yep, keep going, Brent. Keep going. Houston, that's down. Okay. So now these are off by an inch and a half. That one is pretty good. So my plan at this point was just take a sledgehammer and just bang the cradles a little bit to align up with the thing. They can move a little bit this way.
We're gonna have fireworks after this one, man.
Hey,
what? Yay! Yay, we flipped.
Yeah. is assume that the cradles are plumb and get those all locked in and then move the boat into the cradle.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, I did my best to make these cradles, you know, as like they were laser level, like square, you know. So far,
baby.
It's so close, I can't tell which end is off. That's a good sign.
Look at that level. Holy cow.